Hey guys, I'm Venkat, and in this video, we'll understand how an inner join, left join, right join, full join, and even cross join returns the same row count. We have two tables here, table A and table B. As you can see, both the tables have just one column each. Table A has two rows and table B has three rows. To join both these tables, we're using column A in table A and column B in table B. So basically, joining column A in table A with column B in table B. Now, here is the question asked in the interview. Actually, one of our YouTube channel subscribers faced this question in an interview. And here's the question. However we join these two tables, inner join, left outer join, right outer join, full outer join, or even cross join, we get the same number of rows as the result, that is 6 rows. How is this possible? Can you please explain? This is the question. Let's look at this in action. In the interest of time, I have the create script ready, so let's execute it. There we go, both the tables are created. Now, let's populate both the tables with test data. Again, in the interest of time, I have the insert script ready, so let's execute it. Let's select the data to make sure we have everything as we want it to be. There we go. As expected, we have two rows in table A and three rows in table B. Now, let's try inner join. Select column A, comma column B from table A, inner join, table B, on. We want to join column A in table A with column B in table B. Execute the query. There we go. We have 6 rows. Now, let's try left outer join. Make a copy of the query. Change inner join to left outer join. Execute the query. Again, we have the same number of rows, 6. Now, in the interest of time, I already have queries for right outer join, full outer join, and cross join. So let me paste those three queries here. Now, let's execute all the queries. There we go. All the 5 queries executed successfully. Flip over to the messages tab. Notice all the 5 queries returned the same row count, 6 rows. Now, let's understand what's going on. How come all the different types of joins return the same count of rows? The answer is actually very simple. If you take a look at the data in both the tables, every row in table A matches with every row in table B. So what we get back is a Cartesian product, that is the number of rows in table A multiplied by the number of rows in table B. So in essence, what we have here is a cross join. Table A has 2 rows and table B 3 rows. Every row in table A matches with every row in table B. So irrespective of the type of join, we get the Cartesian product 6, that is 2 rows in table A multiplied by 3 rows in table B. Now, what do you think is the result going to be if we add one more row with a value of 1 to table B? Want to take a guess? Pause the video right now and give it a shot. What's your answer? Is it 8? If so, you are correct. But how? Well, the same logic, Cartesian product, 2 rows in table A multiplied by 4 rows in table B. So the answer is 8. Let's actually prove it. Execute the insert query. Now, let's execute all the 5 select queries. Click on the messages tab. There we go. 8 rows returned by each query. Are you still confused? Let me explain with another example. Drop both the tables, that is table A and table B. Let's recreate them. Notice the 2 create table queries, they are the same as before, except we now have a second column called some value in both the tables. Let's insert some data. Notice even the insert queries are the same as before. The only difference is we are now supplying value for the second column, some value. Now, the select queries. In addition to column A and column B, we also want to select some value from table A. Let's give it an alias, table A some value. Similarly, some value column from table B as well. Let's call it table B some value. Let's include the same select list on the rest of the four queries, that is left outer join, right outer join, full outer join, and cross join. Execute all the queries. Notice the output. It takes the first row in table A, that is the row which has the value A1, and returns every row in table B. So we have A1B1, A1B2, A1B3. The same happens even with the second row in table A. So we have A2B1, A2B2, A2B3. Hope this explains why we have the same number of rows for every join type. If you're new to joins, please check out our videos on SQL Server joins. I will include the video link as well as all the queries we used in this demo in the description of this video. This is Venkat. Thank you for watching.